Soldier Field in Chicago. It's the NFC Divisional Round Playoffs on EA Sports.
Venue has hosted some memorable playoff games over the years, and these Bear fans are hoping to make some new memories today at Soldier Field in Chicago. Ahead, we'll decide the second entrant to next week's NFC title game, as we've got a great one in store between the Dallas Cowboys and the Chicago Bears. With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best. Patterson complete, and he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play, and that'll bring up fourth down. Well, they try to swing it out left into the flat, complete, but really nice open field tackling.
And they played that one like a great boxer. They were on their toes on that one. They weren't back on their heels reacting to the play. No, they saw it, came right for it, and made a nice tackle for lost yardage.
On is the punt team now as this one's sent away. It'll be a 41-yard punt, given 5 on the return. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a 1st and 10. So out come the Cowboys under head coach Mike McCarthy. As we get a peek at their dynamic signal caller hailing from Mississippi State, it's Dak Prescott.
Any more than did his part in the wild card win with 3 touchdown passes. Now, he's going to get a bigger test here in round 2, but his unit is in rhythm, and they're playing as well as they have all year long. I wouldn't be surprised if this defense, though, tried to get after him early with a little extra pressure. If he can handle that, he can have another big game, though.
Now it appears we're going to get whistles and a stop, a man down on the return. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a 1st and 10 at their 36-yard line. Here's the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And unable to get downhill there, as he'll take this up to about the 37. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
You know, it's not just all athleticism from defensive linemen. Let's give him a little credit.
And that's caught inside the 35. Prescott. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. It'll go as an impressive 31-yard gain.
We saw these guys have some big plays in their wild card win last week, and they're certainly going to need to continue to put up plays like we just saw there if they hope to continue to move on in these playoffs.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's 1st and 10, just outside the 30. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. And he's got Ezekiel Elliott. And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. This gain not quite as good as the last, but still over 40 yards between the two. Come on. First down carry by Elliott. And he's got four down inside the 20 to the 18.
With the give to Ezekiel.
Now a second down and six.
Down at the 18-yard line. A gain of four. It's now second and six.
They'll run with Elliott. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11.
Yeah, once more, strong running. Excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
Now a first and 10 at the 11. Here's Elliott. And a pickup of about four down inside the 10 to the 8-yard line. Facing a second and six from the 8.
4 yards on the pickup.
They'll try to throw now. Prescott. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. Play number seven now coming up on the drive. 35.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because...
That is caught. It's Cooper for the Cowboy touchdown.
To Amari Cooper.
It's a 6-yard touchdown pass, and the Cowboys have taken the early lead. One of the keys to their long winning streak has been scoring first, an ideal drive right there, getting the first 6 points of the ball game.
Do you go back to our meeting with the offensive coordinator?
Oh,
remember
yeah.
What he told us?
Absolutely.
With some teams, I script to probe in the early part of the game. Other teams, I script to attack. They've been in attack mode for these ball games and continue that in this one.
And this is up and good to make it 7-0 Cowboys. So that drive goes 8 plays, and it's capped off with a Cowboys touchdown. Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. On the return, here's the dangerous Cordarrelle Patterson. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21.
First and 10 at their own.
Chicago works their way back onto the field here for their second drive of the game. And they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Just like that, a pickup of 20 on their first play from scrimmage.
That was good, tough running right up the middle, and if the defense can't penetrate and make him slow his pace or change direction, that's often the end result.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And he was hit as he threw it there, and it forces it incomplete. Second and 10, a very chilly day here, but no snow. And I got to say, if it's going to be this cold, I want snow. You should see Charles' face. He's looking at me like I'm crazy. 5 yards, now it's third and 5.
The tackle made at the 47-yard line. It's a gain of 5.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And Robinson with a big catch. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. His first reception of the divisional round matchup, and it's good for a first down as well.
Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes when they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air, and sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it, and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there as they were able to connect. And he will go down. A Cowboy sack. Leighton Vander Esch wreaking havoc with a sack.
And plays like that really hurt play calling. They had a really nice gain on the previous play, but gave about half the yardage back on the sack. Excellent pressure up front. Nowhere to go with the football. Down he goes.
So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. The throw over the middle, taken in. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. Got to get to the 26 for a first. This is third down.
Brings up third down and seven.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. Caught out left side by Robinson. And he will have the Bears first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. He had three catches last week. That one, his third on this drive alone.
Oh, that was a pretty route right there, because it's all about finding a window on a route like that. He lined up on his left, ran the deep in route over the middle, and the ball was right where it needed to be. Really good trust between quarterback and receiver. Really good completion.
Clock rolling as we hit the midway point of this first quarter. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. That is caught at the 7-yard line. He's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
Brings up second and 1.
On second down, Montgomery. And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7.
That's a really alert defense there, because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft, and able to really make a big-time play for their defense.
Here comes play number 9 now as they come up on a 3rd and 3. Let's go, D. And Miller will pull this one in. He's got it for the Bears touchdown. A 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Bears are an extra point away from tying the football game. Well, there was a little extra pressure with that one because it was third down. He didn't care. He snagged it with one hand like it was routine.
The key is to make a play in a tough situation. Doesn't matter how. And in this case, one-handed gets it done. Terrific play for us to watch.
Cairo Santos on to try the extra point. It's up and good. So these teams match touchdowns here in the first quarter, and we're tied 7-7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And with a marker down, he's up just past the 25-yard line, but I think they're going to be going backwards. Let's check the call. And the holding penalty sets them back inside the 20 as they get going on this drive. A first down throw for Prescott. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Elliott. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
One play has him to the 37 here for 1st and 10. This is Elliott. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
A run here with Dak. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. Give him 14 on that one and a first down. And this, I mean, it's certainly something to watch out for. He is not afraid to call his own number on plays like that. And here he takes it for good yardage.
And we know this defense prepared all week for this, but sometimes when you see it in person, it's a whole different ball game. And all that preparation, it goes right out the window.
So into Bear territory now. This is first and 10 at the 45-yard line. Draw play, Elliott. And he's going to be stacked up right at the line of scrimmage. Nothing there for him. Second down.
The line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. Second and 10.
At the looking to throw on second down. Prescott got an open man. It's Michael Gallup. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Bears' 34-yard line.
First down, Dallas.
From the shotgun, a give to Elliott. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
Well, they came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football. I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
Prescott on first down. He's going to find Gallup here complete. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
They have three tight ends in that formation. That's almost a universal sign that they're planning to run the football. But how about the defense there? They met force with force and caused a stack up behind the line of scrimmage and threw him for a loss.
They're trying to keep the drive going. This will be play number 8. It's 3rd and 2. Prescott to throw it. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free and it's 4th down.
It's now 4th down.
Now Prescott on 4th down. Open man, Lamb. It's complete. Yeah, the Cowboys are going to have 1st and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. Some collective exhales over there on the sideline. A big pickup through the air on 4th down to bring up 1st and goal. And he gets halfway home from the 4 down to the 2-yard line. From the 2 now, 2nd and goal. Dak going to hand it to Elliott on the option. And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Cowboys have taken the lead. People always talk about one of his biggest strengths running the football, vision, and he found the spot there, went into the end zone.
You're exactly right about that. It wasn't just the vision, right? Once he saw the gap, decisiveness, made up his mind, and about the power to finish the play. Not only did he get good blocking, he created his own space as well.
Zuerlein now for the PAT. It's up and good, and it's 14-7 now here in the first quarter.
That one in the books as a 12-play drive, and it culminates in a touchdown run by Ezekiel Elliott.
Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. Now it's Patterson. And they will wrangle it down a couple yards shy of the 30.
The Bears take over 1st and 10 at their own 28-yard line.
The Chicago offense set to get started. And they'll be looking to build off of a nice drive last time, a drive that really relied on the quarterback.
Making good decisions, distributing the ball well, distributing it accurately, keeping it away from danger. A really nicely run drive.
But now the defense, what adjustments do they need to make in the passing game?
Pass rush, pass rush, pass rush. Whether it's the guys up front, or maybe you bring additional guys, but you've got to disrupt the timing of them throwing the football.
We'll see if they can disrupt it here. Here's a 2nd and 7. They'll find Miller. That's complete.
The pass.
A gain of 3 last play. This time they double it and pick up 6.
A gain of 6. Brings up 3rd and 1.
On 3rd down.
It's Patterson, and he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. Through one quarter, 14-7, our score.
Bears 7.
On first down, Montgomery. And they get to him after a gain of 6 to the 46.
DeMarcus Lawrence on the stop. A 6-yard pickup brings up 2nd and 4. At the 46.
Second and 4. He completes this into the hands of Miller. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys 40. He'll drop to throw. Oh, that was dangerous.
The pass.
Threw it into coverage, almost picked. But instead, they'll keep it on second down.
Brings up 2nd and 10 at the 40-yard line.
Here's a throw over the middle. It's taken in by his tight end. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34. They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4.
3rd and 4.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. That's caught by Montgomery.
The pass.
And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36.
If you're a selfish player and you're throwing the ball, you're cool with the completion. Maybe not so cool with the yardage loss, though, huh?
Yeah, you went backwards on the yardage. Hey, it kind of works like a sack for the defense there.
Yeah, it's a really big play for them, right? Able to figure it out, sniff it out, and finish it off.
Santos on for the field goal. A 53-yard attempt.
Santos' kick is up and through. But hang on, a flag is down. Now, if it's on the defense, they might decline it and take the points. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
A lack of discipline defensively on 4th down, and now that leads to a 1st and 10. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another 1st down.
1st and goal at the 7-yard line.
Patterson on the carry. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. Give him 2 yards on that one. 2nd and goal now.
A pickup of 2 brings up 2nd and goal at the 6.
Back to the ground, this time Montgomery. And he is in. Touchdown, Chicago. A 6-yard touchdown run. And the Bears are an extra point away from tying the football game. That almost looked too easy, and I think thanks goes to the offensive line for making it look easy.
Yeah, I agree with you totally on that one. I'm not sure how much everyone understands the preparations that go into a game for an offensive line, because there's a reason that running backs and quarterbacks give them big gifts at the end of a season after a big year. The consistency and the continuity it takes to know each other and execute their blocks, it's pretty impressive.
Santos able to tack on the extra point. And we've got a tie game here in a back-and-forth first half. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of 1 there. Now Dallas gets set to take the field. And Charles, the way touchdowns have come so fast and furious for both sides of this thing, it's starting to feel a little bit more like maybe a tennis match than a football game.
Yeah, I like your description there. Maybe we're sitting in a nice royal box watching this type of a game. But let's face it, right now, the way it's going back and forth, it's going to come down to who can get a stop.
The drive starts with a completion, left side. That one good for 10 yards. And that'll make it 2nd and a foot or so. Boy, the evolution of the game
game and how these guys on plays like that can get out of the pocket, keep plays alive. It just makes things so much harder for defenses.
It really does, and we're talking about an era in the game where the quarterbacks are the most athletically gifted that we've seen in a bunch. I mean, when you talk about collectively, it's unbelievable. So their ability to move is practiced now. It's not necessarily, oh, he just took off and you guys figure it out. When he takes off, everyone knows where to go now. They know how to run routes, change things, make themselves presentable for the quarterback. That's a lot of time that they put in on it. It's not just your static 1-2-3. This is where the ball goes anymore.
That catch good for only a couple.
At the 39-yard line.
Looking to throw again on second down. Prescott. It was Roquan Smith who got his big hand in there to knock it away.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating the defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a 3rd and 8. Prescott from the gun. Able to hit his target, Lamb. And they stop him up short of the first down as they get him at about the 43. They get only 4 that time as that leads us to a 4th down.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. So on 4th down, here's Chris Jones to punt it away. That'll be a 41-yard punt, just 1 yard on the return. And it'll be 1st and 10 Bears from deep in their own territory. Here's the Chicago offense coming back out onto the field. The last possession, these guys were able to tie the game with a touchdown. Now they'll have a chance to move out in front.
Yeah, let's give a big assist to the defense who got the ball back. The special teams went out there, handled things. They've got it. They've got momentum. I know they're eager to get out there and put it on display.
Give him 9 there on the first down completion. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable 2nd and 1.
One of the feature points of the in route is being able to make a nice throw to the middle part of the field. And for a quarterback, that's one of the better throws and better looks that he'll get. But he has to be careful not to wait too long and let his receiver wander into some tough territory. If he's late with the ball, he can get his receiver hit and hit hard.
25-yard line.
On 1st down, he'll drop to throw. To the right side, complete to Miller. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, 2nd and 2.
It's a gain of 8. Brings up 2nd and 2 at the 33-yard line.
Here's a 2nd and 2 now from the 33. They run with Patterson. And this will be a Bears 1st down as the tackle made just shy of the 40. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10.
Chicago Bears!
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And this will be caught by Mooney. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 14 yards into Chicago 1st down. A shotgun handoff to Patterson. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage.
No gain on the play. Brings up 2nd and 10.
Back to throw now on 2nd and 10. That's complete to Mooney.
The pass.
They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4.
It's a gain of 6. Makes it 3rd and 4.
Here's the 7th play of this drive. This is 3rd and 4. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he will have the Bears 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another 1st down.
Did you see that route the way that I did? I thought he was trying to get deep.
Yeah, that wasn't the first option.
No, not at all. It came off of that guy, the deep guy, and came underneath on the drag, completed it very well.
Check, 154, 154. I got one, I got one, I got one. Hey, 1-7.
They'll run on first down. Patterson. And he struggles to get a yard here, maybe a yard, down to the 31. The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine.
1 yard gain brings up second and nine.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And he will find his man on the end route. Complete. The Bears on third down. They've been very good, 5 for 7 thus far. This will be third and five.
One of the selling points of the in route is it gives the quarterback a really nice sight line to his receiver, and almost on a direct shot, able to throw the ball to the middle of the field and have a great chance of success as they did on that play. The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. They're going to look to throw. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off inside the 5. Past the 10 to the 11-yard line, and that's where the return stops. They thought they were going to break the tie. The defense had other plans. They were already in field goal range, but boom, an interception.
I don't know if this was a case of being a little bit too greedy with the opportunity to put points on the board, but give credit to the guys on the defensive side. Hung in there, battled, and made a key play.
So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a first and 10. At their own 11. Following the interception, here's Prescott. And he'll hit the slant route. That's caught by Cooper. And he's brought down, but not before they get it across the 20-yard line. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup. Looking to throw, Prescott. And he'll go down. The Bears get there for the sack. Robert Quinn, credit him with the sack, and it goes as a loss of 6.
Okay, was it a breakdown in protection? Did the running back not pick him up? What does it really matter? Sometimes it's just a great play made by the defense. Big time sack.
Protection certainly going to need to be a bit better here on second and 16. Elliott. And they won't fare much better here as he maybe gets back to the line. And after getting tackled, he's still down and looking very slow to get up. We'll check on his status when we get back. The Cowboys on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is third and 16. Out of the gun, here's Prescott. He'll find Lamb, that's complete. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. It'll be a pickup of 14, but they're still a little bit short as it brings up fourth. And on this challenge, the refs have to take a peek and see whether or not the receiver was able to dot the I with both feet.
While making sure that he possesses the football all the way through the catch.
Chris Jones on to punt for the Cowboys.
Well, he challenged the play. It did not pay off.
And that means he lost a timeout in that challenge.
And as a coach, you hate that. Don't know if you took the advice of the player. You threw it yourself, but it didn't go your way.
At the end of the day, it all comes back to the head coach. He has the final determination on whether to actually challenge the play or not. In this case, it didn't pay off for him.
And that's got to be so heartbreaking. You throw that flag, you probably feel really confident. And then all of a sudden, boom, you lose the challenge.
Yeah, when you take a look at it, you're throwing that flag because you believe you're going to be right. And when it comes back the other way, you have to regroup.
Open man is Komet, the tight end. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
8 yards on the pickup. Brings up second and
off the play fake. He'll look to throw. He'll get that complete to his tight end, Komet.
And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Now a look at Smith. Not sure exactly what happened, but he's still down. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. We remind you, as we've done all year, that coming up at halftime, we will visit with Jonathan Coachman, standing by in Orlando. He'll let you know what's going on here on a very eventful divisional round weekend. A throw left side taken in by Kmet. That catch good for only a couple. On play action, they'll throw.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
First and 10. And with that completion, he's now north of 200 yards here in the first half. Boy, a tough start for the secondary defensively.
It is, and it's got to put a dent in their confidence. And, you know, you always want to keep that up and feel like you can always bounce back after plays. But with the kind of numbers he's putting up here, it's starting to wear on them a little bit, I think. So they're looking at each other and trying to figure out what defense will work and how can they play better without getting beat deep for big passes.
Now a man open down the middle of the field. Now the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. So 5 plays on this drive, Charles. All passes, all completions. And just like that, they're in the red zone.
And don't you think the playbook opens up a little bit more now? Because all they've done is throw the football. If you want to run it now, you may very well have them fooled.
Ahead of the chains now, 2nd and 2. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. 8th catch for him now. He's been a big factor. And it's a first down. This will be caught at about the 6. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. That'll bring up 2nd and goal after the gain of 5. And that is caught. Touchdown, Bears. Anthony Miller, as the first half is winding down. And the Bears have broken the tie.
And that touchdown gives them a touchdown lead before they attempt the extra point. What a great way to end the half.
Yeah, great job to put themselves in front. And now, see on the sideline, special teams defense scrambling, saying we want to preserve this for the final moments of this second quarter. Now the point after try for Santos. It's up and good, and that'll make the score 21-14. So that drive takes them down the field in 8 plays. And the end result is a Bears touchdown. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. This is Tony Pollard. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
And this offense going to elect to burn a timeout with 5 seconds remaining in quarter number 2. Man open, that's complete to Dalton Schultz. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. Final play of the half, Prescott. He's going to loft one deep over the middle. And a little floater there, but it'll wind up incomplete, falling to the ground. So we've come upon halftime here in this NFC divisional round matchup as we send you down to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports halftime report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. We'll get back to you and Charles in a minute. But first, time to give the folks at home a look at what's going on around the NFL. Meanwhile, in our game, we're set up for a terrific second half. So to find out who will advance to the NFC title game, let's send it back out to Brandon Gott.
Okay, coach, appreciate it. A one-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. A trip to the NFC title game hanging in the balance. Second half action back underway.
Tony Pollard on the return. The Cowboys take over first and 10. At their own 20.
Out come the Cowboys now as they'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They'll look for a drive to tie this up, down 21-14 as they have it first and 10. Man, I just love being in this stadium. So much history, tradition, so many great teams and games, and we're seeing a pretty good one right now, hotly contested in the third quarter. Dak dropping this one off for Zeke. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out by a few inches. That'll be a first down. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Wilson. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. A gain of 6 there on first.
It's a pickup of 6. Brings up
throwing again on second down. Prescott to the left side and complete for Amari Cooper. Oh, now he's stripped. He lost the football. And this is picked up by the Bears. And a super return as he gets us all the way down inside the 25-yard line. These defenses have become so opportunistic, and no matter what you're playing, in this case wide receiver, you got to be careful.
Certainly do, because there is a phrase in today's football that we use all the time, completing the process of the catch. Well, it's after you do that where the trouble begins, right? Meaning you've tucked it away, you're trying to get downfield, but someone's always coming up trying to rake at the ball and knock it free.
First down, here's the run with Montgomery. And a good run as he manages 7 yards down to the 17.
Montgomery, the ball carrier. He's taken down at the 17-yard line. It's a gain of 7. Brings up second.
Second and 3. He's going to be sacked back at the 23-yard line.
But, partner, we know they came out of the locker room down on the scoreboard, but I will guarantee you, the defensive side of the ball got super emotional. They can come out and play with aggressiveness, with fury, because they don't have to be quite as precise, and it paid off for them on that play, didn't it?
Sure did. Excellent play, really setting the tone for this third quarter. An important play right here, 3rd and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
On 3rd down, he'll drop to throw. Trying to get it to Robinson, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jordan Lewis.
Well, this is simply a great read by a defensive back. It's 3rd and 10, so he sits right on where the yard to gain marker is, knows it's going to be a route around that distance, makes his read, breaks on the football, and makes a terrific play.
The Dallas offense back out onto the field. And a fumble last time. Ball security. Talk about it all the time in the National Football League. They've got to be better at it on this drive.
Don't you think that when every team gets together for the first time, I don't care if it's OTAs, mini camps, first day of camp in the regular season, ball security comes up about, what, the second sentence of the coach's address?
And those are so many drills focus on that.
All the time, and they do drills to make it even tougher to simulate game situations. Doesn't always work out, though. That's a nice run right there, able to get to the outside, and so many times defenses say, okay, we've got you hemmed in. But if you're running the football, at least you know where everyone is coming from. You don't have to worry about the backside at all. That allows you to run with a little bit more confidence as you traverse down the field.
So 1st and 10 now from the 30. They keep on the ground with Elliott. And he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32. Akeem Hicks that time on the tackle.
A gain of 2. Brings up 2nd and 8.
On 2nd down, Elliott. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a 3rd down.
No gain on the play. And it brings up 3rd down.
Prescott. And that will be incomplete.
intended for Cedric Wilson. Incomplete.
So it doesn't look like they're going to be able to build off the turnover.
Well, the defense certainly did its part. It got them the football. But you're exactly right. It looks like they're going to have to punt this one away. And it's not a turnover, but doesn't it feel like one after grabbing the momentum with the defensive play?
Yeah, and they had all that momentum after getting the football, and now zapped right back in the other direction. His first punt, 48 yards. This one looks equally as good. Call that a 46-yard punt with a net of 40 on the 6-yard return. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. They'll start on the ground with Montgomery. And they're able to get this one across the 35. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down. Successful toss play to the right there. It's interesting, teams seem to run the toss a lot more to the right than to the left.
It's usually a little more natural. Right-handed quarterback, typically your power side running the ball is to the right side with your guard and your tackle. In college football, they used to call it student body right because you had everyone on that side, including a fullback leading. In the pros, they don't call it that, but it's still the same result.
Now throwing on first down and completing it. A gain of 6 there on first. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and 4.
Brings up second and 4 at the 41-yard line.
Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. It's picked up by the Cowboys. And this is going to be brought back for a fumble return touchdown by the Cowboys. So they were down by a touchdown, probably just hoping the defense could hold them, maybe force the punt. Instead, they force the turnover and take it into the house.
Well, the plan was perfect. That's exactly what they wanted. Instead, they got a lot more than that. Big-time capitalization by taking the ball away and putting it in the end zone.
Now Zuerlein on and the extra point. He's got it, and we're all tied at 21. The scoop and score, always an exciting play in football, and we witnessed it there, grabbing it off the ground and then rumbling it into the end zone for 6. A couple of teams locked into a good one here. 21 all the score as the kick's away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here, right at the 30-yard line.
The Bears take over first and 10 at their own 30.
The Bears offense now gets set to head back onto the field. So first and 10 now from the 30. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Flushed out right. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk at the 45. The escapability in evidence there is that one. Good for 15 and a first.
Looks to me, partner, like he's learned a little bit because earlier in the game, I think he was trying to force a lot of throws into his windows that just weren't open.
Yeah, the interceptions had plagued him, especially a second interception, really a bad throw. So maybe a better decision there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. I think he learned from earlier in the game, and he's applying it now.
The big play to start him out has him at the 45 already. And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on first and 10. DeMarcus Lawrence in on the tackle. Second and 8 coming up.
2 yards on the pickup. It's second and 8 at the 47-yard line.
And that'll be incomplete. So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a 3rd and 8.
Third down and 8.
Back to throw here. Gonna let one fly for Robinson. And this is, oh my goodness, he pulled it in one-handed.
They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
I don't think we'll ever get enough of watching one-handed catches, and when they pay off, they are spectacular. But how about the times they don't pay off, and coaches go, two hands, still works.
I know, but they go for them so often now that I'm almost starting to take them for granted.
Yeah, that's unbelievable, isn't it? Because these are sensational type plays.
Especially that one with a defender right there.
Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. This will be caught just inside the 10. And here he'll get it down to the 7. Not much there, only a yard.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
Right there, 54, right there.
And he's got it. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. That time the completion goes for 4 yards, and we're set up with a third and goal.
It's now third and...
They'll run for it with Montgomery. And he takes this one in for a Bears touchdown. David Montgomery, his second touchdown of the night. And the Bears have broken the tie. Able to punch it in on third down makes it easier for those guys on the sideline. They didn't have a fourth down decision to make.
Yeah, could you feel the exhale? Because they were already thinking ahead, as all the good coaching staffs do. Anticipating, will we have to make the call? They already had it lined up, never even got to it.
Santos now to add the PAT. It's good. That makes it a 28-21 game. So this drive spans 7 plays. And it was David Montgomery's touchdown run that polished it all off. Now after the touchdown here, Santos to kick this one away. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. And let's gaze our attention on Ezekiel Elliott. He's had a good performance, moved the ball effectively on the ground. Of course, he has the one touchdown.
And when you're able to move it as effectively as you've described, that leads to finding a way into the end zone, and now he's just trying to do it for a second time. And, of course, with that comes additional yardage.
Yeah, looking for additional yardage, and again, that second score here in the third quarter.
And this throw a bit late as he couldn't reach back for it.
It's now second and 10 at the 25-yard line.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Now Elliott. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1-yard gain up to the 26.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
And force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
Third down, it's Prescott. Open man, Lamb, it's complete. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. It's a gain of 16 in the Dallas first down.
That's a pretty throw right there. That ball's in the air a long time, but it's right on the money on the right sideline. A really good route. Moving the defenders towards the middle of the field before breaking to the sideline. What a completion there. Big time arm strength, very nice route.
Tonight for the workhorse, Elliott.
And very little daylight there. He'll get a couple up to the 44.
The tackle made at the 44-yard line. A gain of 2. Brings up 2nd and 8.
They go to Elliott again.
And this is going to be a Cowboys first down as he's got this up to the 45-yard line.
He was brought down at the 45-yard line.
A tough run by Ezekiel Elliott, the fourth overall pick in the 2016 draft.
If you watch tape of him in college, you saw plenty of those runs because I know the highlights showed him in the open field breaking away from people, but that's how he wore down defenses, those exact type of runs.
So into Bear territory now. This is first and 10 at the 45-yard line. Prescott from the gun. And nearly picked off there. And it would have been a great time for their first pick. Instead, it's second down.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
A second down throw for Prescott. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down. Now play number 7 of the drive as they're looking at a 3rd and 10. Now Prescott. Letting one fly deep for Cooper. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. Trying to cover Cooper there a little too closely.
And he's such a tough cover because he runs his routes so well. Hard to stay with him and hard to figure out exactly where the break points are. And in this case, he created another pass interference call.
And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13.
A 3-yard pickup brings up 2nd and 7.
Again, it's Elliott. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line.
Elliott,
3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other 3 here on 3rd down?
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
Here comes play number 9 now as they come up on a 3rd and 3. Prescott to throw it. They'll set up the screen to Elliott. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. Well contained there defensively. The screen gets only a yard, and it's 4th. Instead of throwing it downfield, Charles, they just tried to dump it underneath there. You like the call?
I do. I think it's a high percentage play because you get the completion, and what you're counting on is your back to use his legs and his elusiveness to make people miss and pick up the first down. In this case, it didn't happen.
And the move from Mike McCarthy is going to be to keep the offense on the field here on 4th down. They're going for it. They'll run for it with Pollard. And he will not even make it back to the line of scrimmage. They'll get neither the touchdown nor the first down. And the Bears will get the football back.
Turnover on down.
Well, their first 4th down attempt earlier was successful. This one backfires for a turnover on downs.
I like their aggressiveness. I like what they're doing. They got it the first time they went for it. Why not a 2nd time? I don't think they'll be daunted from attempting it again. If you're on the defensive side of the ball, though, any 4th down stop is a big momentum play. I'll tell you what, this defense hasn't played its best, but they're still right in this football game. And if they keep making plays just like that, they're going to give their offense a chance.
After the loss to start out, here's 2nd and 11.
And let's pin the mirrors back and go full strength.
On the carry, it's Montgomery. And able to get it across the 20 before they get to it. 12 yards there and a 1st down.
I'm not sure how much more evidence they need, partner, than to understand that if they don't start to slow him down, it's going to be a long afternoon here at the stadium because he is just shredding them at this point. And let's face it, coming into the game, they knew he would be the focal point of their attack. This is going to take an 11-man unit on the defensive side to start making plays.
Now on 1st down, he'll drop to throw it. That's the tight end, Jesper Horsted. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in his performance.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. They run. Montgomery, nowhere to go that time. He maybe got a yard up to the 40.
He's tackled at the 40-yard line. A gain of a yard brings up